Hi there and welcome to Catchment of Resources. This is Viro. This is part of the series on the use of OpenFAST. OpenFAST, which is able to do the design of wind turbines right from the blades to the towers, as well as the electrical and mechanical parts to the foundation. This application is actually open source. The other applications like this will do the design of offshore and onshore wind turbine structures, as well as even for offshore oil and gas. But most of these applications are expensive and difficult to access. But this application is open source and is free to use. There are several students who may be requiring this skill to use this application for oil and gas or for renewable energy technologies. So it's good for students to actually have an understanding of this application in order for them to have the mindset to be recruited in companies that have those applications which are more expensive, which they can also use. So remember to like this video, subscribe to this channel, as well as share this video to students who may actually require it in order to build their technological skills. Also, for those who want to do personal and private design of wind turbine structures, this tool is a complete tool that can actually help them to make this possible. Previously, I've looked at how you can actually run OpenFAST and actually simulate the design of wind turbine based on the precompiled binaries which is available on OpenFAST repository. From there, you are able to actually run the application and see the design results. In the next video after that, I was able to show how to build OpenFAST yourself. For those who actually want to write code or want to adjust the code from OpenFAST, it's possible to actually make modifications to the code as well as run the application and then provide your own executable files which you then run like we did for the first part of this video for the precompiled binaries. In this video, we are going to look at how to test OpenFAST when you have built it yourself to see how it works well with the baseline codes and files which are already there to see whether everything is functioning properly. In subsequent videos, we are going to look at how to update the input files to know which sections should be updated in order to do design of wind turbine blades which are different from 63 meters, the different inputs that need to be updated. Those are going to be considered in future video in this series. So for now, we are going to look at how we can test OpenFAST using Visual Studio. In order to test OpenFAST after building it, you need some regression test files which have been inbuilt with OpenFAST, and they represent baseline of what a design with the application should look like. Basically, in order to test OpenFAST, there are several steps which you follow. You can see here from step 1 to step 5. You can see here from step 1 to step 5 how to test OpenFAST. From step 1 to step 3 is similar to what we have done with respect to building OpenFAST using Visual Studio. And you can see here, this is broader than what we did in part 2. You can see here that you need to build discon files as well as OpenFAST solution files. When you open the OpenFAST folder, you will see that there are several solution files. And if it's required for some certain functionality in OpenFAST, you will need to build additional solution files rather than just the OpenFAST file, which we did in the beginning. If you do just one solution file, it's possible that other functionalities may not be available to use in your OpenFAST executable file. For example, some of the electrical functionality where you're able to design for the servo dyne may not be possible if there are some certain files that have to do with discon are not available as executables as well, or they have not been fully built. So you can see the different steps in order to test the regression files. Step 1 all the way to step 3 we have done previously, so you can check out part 2 of this video series to see how it was done. From there, you continue at step 4 where you prepare the regression files. And after step four, from step four, you look at how to prepare the regression test. And then in step five, you actually carry out the testing where it's comparing the regression text files as the baseline compared to the folder where you have already copied it in the build folder for the regression test. So it's comparing those two baseline files to see that the values still match each other. It may get a little tricky here depending on the version of the application you are using or the system when you actually want to run this test, because you can see here where it talks about the different syntax that you need to use in order to test. Because you have from the OpenFAST documentation, you see how you're supposed to use certain identifiers, sort of like the Windows, the compiler, that's Intel. Then you provide some tolerance with respect to the iterations. So you see that there's a certain syntax in order for you to run this test. For example, you need to indicate the kind of tolerance in the value. Then you also need to indicate what code you are going to use. You see, initially I use the codes based on the documentation where I have Windows, I have Intel, as well as the tolerance for the iterations close to the end of the code line. But I received an error showing that there are some syntax I placed there which are incorrect. So reading the error information, I was able to understand that it's not the last data on the line of code is requiring absolute tolerance as well as relative tolerance. So just to allow the process to go, I just changed the numbers. I removed the Windows and the Intel and just left the other information. Then I added a copy of the tolerance value. So rather than having the 1e^-5, I now added another value to be 0.5 e^-5, sort of like reducing the tolerance. It's just a value I use in order to allow the application to run. So basically, that's how to build as well as test OpenFAST using Visual Studio. In the next video in this series, we're going to look at the different input files that can be updated and what information should be updated in order to design wind turbine blades and structures for different sizes, right from the blade diameter to the tower height and the specific type of foundation. This is Catchment of Resources. Remember to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and share this video to those who need it.